It's nearly time for afternoon tea. Leave it to me. It's an electro monument. No wonder. Let me try to activate it with a bit of electro power. Stand back, sweeties. When it comes to wet enemies, I've got them covered. Oh, another wind current. Let's ride it up from here. Set off between electro-charged opponents. The electrical discharge caused by friction is only a little less shocking than love at first sight. Oh, you want to know about this gem? You're kidding. You're seriously asking? This is a vision. It's used by the Chosen to draw on elemental powers. In terms of mysticism, I suppose you could call it a magical lightning rod. Vision? Just where exactly are you from? Are you a hilly churl with some level of reasonable intelligence? No, I doubt it. After all, hilly trolls aren't exactly known for their smarts. And you, you'd more or less qualify to be a magister's apprentice. Break it, and we can head home and relax. The thought of putting my feet up and relaxing has me all fired up. Dragon of the East, Lion of the South, Wolf of the North, Falcon of the West. They are the four winds of Mondstadt, affiliated with Barbados, the god of Animo. The Dragon of the East, Storm Terror, its real name? Is Dvalin. Though most in Mondstadt seem to have forgotten that in all this Storm Terror business. So now you know why Dvalin is only able to channel three of the Four Winds' power. Because it has been consuming itself from the beginning. Because of hatred, I presume.
Hatred?
Hatred for Mondstadt. Hatred drove it to become something more powerful than the wind itself, to become Storm Terror.
But why would one of the four winds hate the city it was supposed to protect?
As a child of Mondstadt, it's something that's really hard to say aloud. Here, take this. It's a very old story from more than a century ago.
Well, all that lay flow and elemental line stuff Lisa was going on about should hopefully be back to normal. Wanna go back and see how the knights are doing? But if you got anything more interesting to do, Paimon can come too. By the way, we obtained another animalculus in one of the Four Winds temples, right? We might come across more of them in the future, so don't forget to offer them to the statues.
Thank you.
Hi, darling. Are you going to be Lisa's little helper? What? Me? A grand mage? That was a long time ago. I'm just a humble librarian now. Don't worry, darling. I'll take very good care of you. So... Oh, good morning, Jean. Oh, it's you. Sorry, dear. It must almost be time for a nap. You're still up? I'm getting sleepy. I can see how hard you've been working today. Let me think of a way to reward you. It's nearly time for afternoon tea. Why not keep me company for a while? There'll be plenty of time for work later. Today's no good for going out. Did I say that yesterday as well? Today's no good for going out. Did I say that yesterday as well? Perfect weather for sipping a cup of tea while gazing out the window. When I practice my spells in weather like this, I can do half the work for double the impact. I'm just teasing. Such a calming breeze. Perfect for taking a nap, don't you think? I'm not lazy. I just know to save my energy for when I need it most. I like making my own vegetable soup. I put a big bunch of vegetables into a cauldron and stir it with a long spoon. What does it taste like? Here, why don't you try it for yourself? Open wide. I suffer from extreme pumpkin phobia. The fall harvest is a difficult time of year for me, as you can imagine. I wonder if it would be worth the trouble to make all the pumpkins in the world disappear.
Oh. way.
I feel like running. Welcome. How can I help you?
Ooh. Paimon can smell fisherman's toast! Mmm, the aroma is coming from Good Hunter! A thick slice of sup topped with a generous serving of onion slices lightly caramelized by the toasting. Yum, yum! Paimon's made up her mind! It's an emergency! We must order ourselves a generous serving of fisherman's toast from Good Hunter, pronto! It's on you, of course. It's so delicious! Hum, hum, hum. Good Hunter's Fisherman's Toast is the best! This might surprise you, but it's actually a classic Mondstadt recipe that anyone can cook. You can try cooking it yourself if you have the ingredients. Can your cooking skills surpass that of Good Hunter's? Why, Paimon would love to be your personal taster! Don't you let me down!
Thank you. doesn't sound very good.
This is bad. Such a hassle. Oh, thank the Thousand Winds. Your arrival must be the grace of the gods. If I may ask, envoy sent by the Animo God to save this mere mortal, could you spare a moment?
Ew, cut it out.
I cannot let my peers hear about this. I cannot seek help from anyone else but you. Please. Let us move to somewhere more fit for such conversations. Let's talk in the courtyard, just outside headquarters.
What's with the sneakiness?
Thank you.
Marsha Beat? Beat?
This place will do.
Tell us what it's about already!
How should I begin? Oh, right. Let me tell you a secret first. It's a secret of my past, and I confide in you to keep it.
Don't worry, my lips are sealed.
As a matter of fact, my grandfather was a pirate.
Oh.
Wait, why do you sound so blithe? Do you think I'm making it up? Look at my eye patch. I inherited it from my grandfather, and this is solid proof that we are related by blood. My, how could you not know such common knowledge? This is no different from children inheriting their hairstyles from their parents. Yesterday, I was glancing through the notes my grandfather left and stumbled upon records that spoke of a treasure.
Treasure?
According to his notes, the treasure is buried in the lost Arcadian ruins.
Treasure.
But the location of the ruins is currently unknown. I've tried searching for clues. Treasures that consist of nothing but gold and gems are third-rate treasures. My grandfather's treasure is a sword. A magic sword that grants the wielder unrivaled power.
Oh, wow!
The sword was dropped from Celestia into the sea by a god. It was later salvaged by my grandfather's crew by pure coincidence. The moment he gripped the sword, thunder roared, billows howled, and the clear skies were suddenly swallowed by raging winds. With the might of the magic sword, my grandfather went on to defeat a Hydra, a silver-haired banshee, a wicked abyss dragon. But the immense power of the sword enticed many more greedy pirates. To avoid meaningless conflicts, my grandfather hid the magic sword. The world we live in is fascinating, full of unknown and inexplicable wonders.
Holy moly, that's just insane!
A gang of treasure hoarders has been very active lately, and many ruins have had their relics stolen by them. I'm afraid that they will soon discover the Arcadian ruins, and the magic sword will be lost.
We won't let it fall into the wrong hands! We must get the sword before them! You just rest assured that we are here to help!
Wow. Great. Please keep it a secret. I'll wait for your good news.
Hey, so what you think? Isn't it exciting? We're talking about a super duper powerful sword. Well, let's go to the Adventurers Guild and see if we can find out more. The adventurers should know more about the ruins, right?